How to cope with the pressure of cat preparation? And once again, one of those beautiful questions for which I have no answer. Nobody has a great answer for this. This is a magical question. If you crack this, then if you're a sportsman or a movie star or any kind of performer, you're a genius. And so a big part is coping with pressure. So I'm going to give some pointers, some starting points, a list of do's and don'ts, and some ideas to keep in mind. To start with, don't make this exam the biggest deal in your life. You can't go into this exam and saying the next 3 hours are going to shape how the next 30 years are going to be. It is not that big an exam. And so there are 100 avenues showcasing what you're about. This is one such. If it works, brilliant. If it doesn't work, let's go for the remaining 99. And so you've got to have that belief and you've got to go in with that attitude. Very vital, very pivotal. So don't increase the importance of this exam. It is not such a big deal. And so, second thing, don't burn your bridges. Don't put all your eggs into one basket. So if you have a bad boss, don't start screwing that relationship further under the assumption that you're going to go to an MBA any which way. Don't mess with your academic performance. Don't mess with your GRE or GATE or what other exam you have in mind. Don't screw your appraisals. Don't take those chances because all of those will make you more desperate when you go in for this exam. That's the song. Finally, have a lot of fun preparing for this exam. You've got to consciously take effort to enjoy this process. It's a fabulous process. One way or the other, I've been preparing for this exam for 6 years. I train students and I take the exam. And so this is what I do. And I like the actual preparation aspect of my exam because there are a bunch of questions to solve, a bunch of questions to set. I enjoy that. It's good puzzles, some very interesting logical reasoning puzzles and interesting data sets to think about, what not to like. I read for an hour, hour and a half every day. If I were not writing this exam, that would be my preferred entertainment option any which way. You read and get an acquired taste for reading because you're preparing for CAT. In and of itself, that's a great thing for the next N years of your life, whether you go to an MBA or not. And so you're going to solve a bit of math, become number friendly, do a lot of reading. Current affairs and otherwise, so because we're going to become smarter, with more knowledge, and more comfort with reading. We're going to do some puzzles and data analysis. What's not to like? So prepare with the idea of enjoying that thing. Take the mock head on and say, look, I'm going to push myself real hard for 3 hours and see if I can survive this. The more of the fun aspect you have, you can load onto your preparation, the less stressful it is. If preparation is not stressful, exam is not going to be stressful. And so consciously take an effort to include this into your routine. Best wishes.